We've seen how we can widen columns and increase the row height, remove columns, add columns, etc. As well as being able to do all of that, we can actually hide columns and rows from view. Hidden rows and columns do not print, so that would be one reason for wanting to hide them. You know they're hidden when you do it, so it's not like you can't find them, but it's for that printing facility or even just for on-screen use. If we take the employee's working file, I might not be interested in seeing Miss Mary Wallace, so I want to hide her row of information. Well, I go to row 7 and select. I can then right-click, and you'll see there's a hide and unhide option. So I could hide row 7. Now, you know row 7's missing, because you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. It's not like it's hidden away and you can't tell. We could hide more than one row. Let's take a little patch here. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Right-click, hide, and they disappear. Again, we know they're not there because there's a little mark between 13 and 19 and the numbers don't run consecutively. So we can hide rows. We can hide columns. So we select column G. We can right-click the little heading here and choose hide. And row G is removed. We can hide multiple columns. So we multiple select the columns, right-click, hide, and they're gone. Again, you can tell. We know there are letters missing between N and S. But the advantage is, if we now print, we only print what we can see. So how do we get them back? Well, we click on row 8, right-click on hide, and nothing happens. We click on row 6, right-click on hide, and nothing happens. The reason that nothing happens, Excel doesn't know which of our hidden rows, and we've got quite a few, we would like to return. So I actually need to highlight the before and the after. So I drag from 6 across where 7's hidden into 8. Then when I right-click and unhide, you'll find that number 7 comes back because it knows where it is now. It says, oh, you want that one back. Okay, no problem. And the same with our other little set here, 13 to 19. We highlight 13 to 19, right-click, unhide. And anything that is hidden between the two selected rows, 13 and 19, is then unhidden. Now, if we just hide 14 again, you'll find there is a little marker there that you can get with your mouse. We can click and hold. You've got to have that cursor in the right place, otherwise you'll just keep increasing the height of 13. Now, as you bring your mouse down, you see there it's a single solid horizontal line along with the up and down arrow. If you move down a little bit further, there, it became a double, two horizontal lines. If I click and drag now, I can actually unhide row 14 with the mouse. But you've got to get in just the right place. Same with those columns. If I come across to the hidden columns there between N and S, I can drag. So I've dragged R out, but there's still a big line there. Drag Q out, big line. Drag P out, still a big line, and drag O out. And now there isn't a big line there. I can only widen the columns. So that's hiding and unhiding columns and rows.